And we are back. I don't know if I ever mentioned this before, but I'm starting a new school program in September. And I've been doing a bit of work in preparation for it. It's a graduate program. In fact, it's going to be my third graduate program. You know, I just can't get enough of school, so I just keep going back endlessly, it seems. But anyways, this graduate program that I'm starting in September, this will be the first time ever that I've signed up to be a TA, a teaching assistant. And it's funny because the department recommended that, you know, new teaching assistants, they should do this like training program. So I signed up for the training program that's offered by my school, and it was last week. It was like a full week-long program, and it was partly online and partly in person, so I had to go to school a few times, which is unfortunate because it's a really long drive from where I'm located. But anyways, so I go to this teaching assistant program, and they're supposed to, you know, like train you on how to be a competent teaching assistant. And I don't know, I didn't really like the experience. They were like, the big takeaway is that they were trying to teach you this like teaching framework. And what I mean by that is that they want you to use this framework in order to prepare your lessons, essentially. And I didn't really like the framework. I mean, it didn't really work with my teaching style. However, like, I was aware enough to realize that they're not telling you have to use this framework. They're just giving you another tool, right? Another tool in your teaching toolkit. You don't have to use the framework. It's just something to get you going, essentially. But I think a lot of the students in the class, a lot of the other, teaching assistants that were in this training program, you know, I think they had it in their head that, you know, now they have to use this framework. You know, they've been taught to use this teaching framework. That's what they have to use. And I really didn't like that. And it kind of reminds me of one of the reasons why school can be a bit of a pain in a similar sense, because you're marked on whether something is right or something is wrong. And the teacher of the class determines what is right and what is wrong. And a lot of the times there's like a rubric or something that you're marked against. And I've never liked that, because there's more than one way to solve a problem, at least in, you know, what I'm studying. In math and some sciences, maybe there is only one right answer, but in what I'm doing, that's not always the case. And that's what this whole teaching assistant program kind of reminded me of, is that they're teaching you this framework, which is fine. However, at the end of the program, you actually have to plan and deliver two lessons to your group of peers, and then they provide you with feedback on how they felt you did as a teaching assistant. And I found it kind of unfair, because during the feedback, they were marking you. Well, not really marking. I mean, there's no marks, but let's just call it marking. They were marking you against the framework. So if you didn't follow the framework that they taught you, then essentially you failed. And again, there's no marks, so you can't fail. But it was kind of frustrating, because I don't teach best using that sort of model that they were giving us. So anyways, to kind of wrap up the story here. I'm not sure if it's funny or not, but I think it's funny. During the first lesson that I delivered, I decided to follow the model, the framework that they gave us, and it was fine. I mean, out of the little group that I was in, I felt like I was probably the best at delivering the lesson and the framework. But then I told them at the end, after they gave me the feedback and after the advisor, whatever you want to call them, told us that we all did a good job and blah, 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 and then gave us some feedback of her own. At the end of it, I told them, I said, this time I followed your model, your framework, but I don't like it. And tomorrow, when I have to deliver my second lesson, I'm going to completely ignore the framework and you'll see my lesson will be much better. You know, it'll be more engaging. It'll be more interesting. It'll just be a fun way to learn. And I'm going to completely ignore this model, this framework that you've taught us. Anyway, so that's what I did. So come the second day, I came in with no presentation, literally nothing. I just went up to the whiteboard and I taught. It was so much better, you know, because the framework that they gave us, it pigeonholes you. You know, you have to deliver your lesson in a certain way. And I really don't like that. I like to engage with the class. I like to have a discussion. And the framework doesn't work for that. It doesn't work for my teaching style. So anyways, everybody agreed that the second lesson that I delivered was much, much better. And, you know, that was something that I told the advisors of this teaching program. I said, you know, take this back to the team and just tell them that, you know, I think the next time you deliver this training program, make sure that the students, you know, the teaching assistants who are taking this program, make sure they know that this framework that you're teaching them, it's just a suggestion. It's just an idea to get them going. They don't have to do it that way. You know, it's not going to work for everybody and it's not going to work for all content. But anyways, bit of a story I decided to share. And I don't know, maybe I'll share some more educational stories as I go on. However, this channel that I made on YouTube is called Scholars Rest, so I'm supposed to be resting here. I'm not talking about school, but I don't know, talking is okay. It's doing the schoolwork that can be stressful. So anyways, getting back in Diablo, and actually one other thing, when I was making the last video for YouTube, I noticed that I'm looking at my display right now, and the colors look exactly what they're supposed to look like. But after this goes into the Elgato capture card and is recorded on OBS, it looks completely different. All the colors are different. For some reason, there's a yellow tinge to the video. And I don't know. I don't know if I didn't notice it in all the other videos that I made, or maybe I just didn't notice it enough to want to fix it. But anyways, in my last video, I decided, no, I'm going to do some color correction and also boost the sharpness a little bit. And the last video that I just uploaded, which was about 2 hours long, I think, that was the one where I did my class quest for the Barbarian. It looks so much better with a little bit of sharpening and color correction. So I've made note of the adjustments that I've done in Final Cut for that video, and I'm just gonna keep doing the same adjustments going forward so that everything looks the same. But I mean, if anyone's wondering why the videos look slightly different now compared to a bunch of the previous videos, that's why. I decided to do some corrections. Anyways, let's hop back into it. Now, you might have noticed that my level has jumped up a bit. I think the last video I made, I don't know, what was I, 44? Maybe 43? And now I'm 46. So I did play a few times with a colleague from work a couple nights ago, so that's why I jumped up. I didn't do any of the story, though. It was just random side missions. I also changed my loadout a little bit. I did end up getting the This imprinted on, this is the Hoda Quake legendary effect or affix, whatever they're called. So I do have that applied, so I am using Hoda instead of Upheaval now. And I also got this, which honestly is incredible. So the legendary property on here is basic skills gain up to 30% attack speed increase. Oh my god, I love this. Speed is everything for me. I want to move fast and I want to attack fast. I'm not too crazy about how high the damage numbers are. I'd rather just see a lot of damage numbers. So anyways, this is really, really, really cool. I found that last time I was playing around, and I think everything else is pretty much the same. And then looking at my my skills, I am using, I guess I can't go down there, can I? Anyway, so I'm still using the same basic skill, Lunging Strike, no change there. I changed Upheaval for Hoda for my core skill. I'm still using Ground Stomp, still using Leap. This is a new one. So I used to use Iron Skin. So whenever I felt I was about to die or in a tough spot, I would pop the Iron Skin. But honestly, I didn't feel like it did that much. And I was so much in a habit of popping it earlier than I should have that it just didn't make sense. So I switched it to Steel Grasp because Steel Grasp will make enemies vulnerable. So I'm going for a higher damage increase here, I've decided. And then I'm still using Iron Maelstrom as well. So yeah, so if the Steel Grasp thing, you know, it doesn't really work out, I might switch it out for something defensive again. Again, I'm not really crazy about Iron Skin, so I might switch it out to like Challenging Shout, potentially. We'll see. Anyway, so for tonight, let's continue with the actual campaign missions. And since I've spent the last 10-12 minutes talking, I'll start to simmer down now. Just focus on the gameplay.
Can we never have peace? Shouting and...
Well, he's still breathing.
He is lucky to be.
That old man there, he claims to be Horadrim, but he drinks like an ox.
He came to town days ago, looking for a servant of the demon Lilith, a pale man. It seems he didn't like what he found.
I see. I will take it from here.
Who are you?
He and I met in the Fractured Peaks. I saw his pale man in a vision, if you can believe it.
Enough. He's yours. Just keep away from the bottle, both of you.
That'll probably be my next video's thumbnail.
Gentlemen, what do you want?
You told me to meet you here, Lorath. Remember?
Of course I remember. I'm just surprised you're not dead. Hand me that bottle.
What happened to you?
I was attacked, obviously, by vast quantities of alcohol. Wielded by my own treacherous hand. There may also have been a brawl with the goats over this patch of mud. But I like to think I triumphed.
Lorath, who is the Pale Man?
The Pale Man is... was... Horadrim.
Horadrim? Then you must know him.
I thought I did, once. His name is Elias. He was my apprentice. He was the one who brought Lilith to Sanctuary. It's possible that I did not take the news very well.
What must we do then?
Find him. Figure out what he's done. And then kill him. Listen. There's a woman here someplace. She has some messages we'll need. And I'm of no use to anyone right now. Could you find her? Enough time has been wasted. Check around the inn.
The Pale Man.
Ask if she's heard from the Orbay Monastery.
No, no word from Orbay. Same as yesterday and the day before. But I have something else. Rumor has it a Pale Man passed through the Abaru Canyon some time ago. Fearsome fellow. Dressed in black. After Lorath's performance last night, I wager he'll want to know.
Strange. I wrote to the Orbay Monastery the day I arrived. The abbot should have replied by now.
Tekrin spoke of a rumor, a pale man seen near the canyons.
The canyons? Why didn't you say so? We go at once. Ugh. But we can't leave Orbay unchecked. Sod it. I'm off to the canyons. You can meet me there or go to the monastery. You seem reliable thus far. Do not prove me wrong.
That was the game giving me a choice. Or do I have to do both? Interesting. And there's a Legion event here, actually, and it's starting soon. Maybe I'll go do that. The last Legion event I did, I died. This is what always happens to me. I plan on coming on here and doing campaign missions, and then I get distracted, and I'm doing something else.
My skill is unmatched. You'll see. Plenty worth keeping.
That was kind of weird. A little bit of lag there.
Ah!
Oh, seems to be quite a few people here. My goal this time is to simply not die. I really don't think I'm actually doing that much, but I'm here, I'm participating. Chains are actually pretty good. It's good to kind of get them all in close right before doing a big attack. gonna kind of go off on my own here just to see how much damage I'm actually doing here. Okay, so I'm doing damage. Dude, I just used my ultimate. You pushed everybody away from me. Oh. Well, that was a waste. One legendary.
Thanks.
At least I didn't die this time. That is the big takeaway there. No altar here. This whole area seems like it would be a good spot for Altar of Lilith somewhere. Take a look down here. Nothing, eh? Yeah, why not? I really need to make some space.
Good fortune.
I don't really know if that saved any space or not, but. But we did it. Oh, actually.
Come, my glass is clean.
What do I need to upgrade this thing? Oh my god, I got everything perfect. Excellent. I got everything for the next one too. Don't you love it when a plan comes together?
Greetings.
This guy is talking to me.
I had hoped to find a witness who saw Elias. Instead, I have a camp of dead merchants. They were slaughtered by demons, that much is plain. But none were summoned here. We should search the canyons.
Could Elias have summoned these demons?
Easily. And assuming he did, he may still be here. Stay close to me.
It's too bad that the chain skill, I can't get it to use one of, it doesn't activate, or no, that's not the right word. It doesn't trigger one of my weapon rotations. For some reason, there is quite a bit of a lag between when I can use, after using the chains, and then when I can use Hoda.
Perfect for working.
Kind of strange. It must be because of the animation.
Close it. Put them down.
too easy. These demons were vermin. I'd expect more from a mage of Elias's ability. Let's search the house.
Today, Master Elias called at my door. I had trouble with my words, so I showed him my carvings. He said he could see my pain in them. The pain of a lonely man who had learned to hate the world. And yet, our mother, Lilith, found me beautiful. He said there are others like me as well. And together, we will build the new world.
What a dumb mess.
Burning hells! We're too late. Elias is long gone. This Genbar is our summoner.
How can you be certain?
Isn't it obvious? Elias finds Genbar alone, friendless, full of anger. So he plays him like a fiddle, offers him Lilith's love and a part in his grand illusion. Then he gives him tools to express his anger.
Summoning scrolls.
Very perceptive. Who knows how long Genbar has stewed in this madness? Let's hope he can still be questioned.
If there wasn't an altar up here, I would have been really surprised. Another intelligence one.
Oh, Mother. Thank you for holding me in my eyes. Your grief fills my heart. I cannot stop my hands from working.
There seems to be Lilith statues all over the place here.
For sending Master Elias to show me the way.
Oh, it looks like my shrine is going to end before this happens. When we stand That's by okay. Your side. It'll make this more interesting. I'm assuming there's going to be a fight here.
The cleansing fire. Visitors. Did Master Elias send you?
Master Elias? Well, yes, in fact, he did. Ours is a very important mission. We have something for the Master, but we had heard he was with you. Do you know where he is?
Liar! Dirty pig's born liar! The Master has all he needs!
What is a pig's born liar?
Now, my riches are to me!
Sounds really cool on my headphones. It's distant and echoey. Big hit right there. Man, look at all the whatever they're called, health potions, whatever they're on the ground.
Bad news first. Gemba was.
I think I need to put
something.
The difficulty up.
It seems Elias has turned up.
But I think torment or no, talking what the hell is it called? I don't think it's torment.
You heard Gemba. The master has all he needs.
World. I think I'm on world tier 2 right now, and I think that's as high as I'm allowed to put it at this time.
Elias gave us a gift, remember? This demon he sent to kill us. It is unique. It requires constant feeding. Human sacrifices, in fact. If I cut open its belly, someone inside might hold a clue. Tell us where it came from. I must have it brought to Cad Bardu for examination. Make yourself useful and head for the Orbe Monastery. See what's keeping that bloody abbot.
I guess I don't really want to walk there. I can't remember why I was holding on to this. It's definitely more damage than what I have. But I need that Hammer of the Ancient Quake on the one I have. So. Gonna have to get rid of that. And you know what? I'll get rid of this too. Because it doesn't have movement speed, I don't want to. Weapon mastery, thorns, total armor, yeah. Like the other one I have on, basic skills grant 20% damage reduction. Yeah, like that. I much prefer that. Get rid of that too. How much money do I have? So I'm low on cash. Should I sell stuff instead of
precious stones? Beautiful.
How much is this stuff worth? Sell value 26. Okay, so it's pretty high. 30. Okay. Oh. Well, apparently I just sold everything. Okay, I didn't mean to do that, but that's fine. Cost money to unsock it too. Oh my god, okay.
Are we buying or selling?
I don't think I have enough to remove this. Yeah.
Are we buying or selling?
That doesn't give me much, eh?
Decent value.
So none of these really give you that much. What about these? Wow. Okay. A bit surprising.
Another day, another traveler.
Oops. I had to put that track on. Okay, oh, I'm going the wrong way. So I'm mostly putting, actually, I could put something in this. I think normally I would put a ruby for life. Yeah. Yeah, let's go with the life. So I'm putting rubies in the armor for the life. I'm putting diamonds in the weapons for damage increase on ultimate skill, and skulls in the amulets and rings for the armor. Whether or not that is the way to go or not, I'm not sure, but that's what I'm doing. What do we have here? Just doing a bit of exploring while I make my way over to the next campaign mission. Man, I really miss having a pet, like in Diablo 3. Something to pick up all my gold. Oh, there we go. Hey. Thank you. This is cool. Wow, I think I actually protected every single one of them. I definitely earned that chest. Normally I'm really bad at protecting people. Oh, this is interesting. When there are at least 5 close enemies, stun them for 5 seconds, but it can only occur every 20 seconds. A shrine buff duration, damage with 2 hand. Physical damage over time, and then intelligence. Resistance. Yeah. I don't know. It's fine. That's interesting. It actually comes with ultimate skill damage. Ugh, but I'd have to get rid of my basic skills. All stats. Yeah, no.
Fortress unguarded. Bad sign.
Like the look of this place.
Is anyone here?
Merde!
The Horodrim Elias and I are not to be disturbed for the remainder of—
Lock the doors!
What about the others? Beelbot!
Do as I say!
Jesus, okay. That wasn't creepy. That came out of nowhere. Search for the dead. Search the dead for a key. Okay. Let me jump up there. Oh, okay. That was badass. That just saved me a bunch of time.
When I walked into the sacristy that day. Finally, my turn to enter the archive and explore the Forge of Darkness. Now, I'd give anything to forget all.
Not a Haradrim word.
Man, this place is big.
Rightly fear the dangers of our scholarship, but ignorance of evil offers little protection from it. Our insights have proven invaluable.
Unto evening, I shall keep it safe. And then...
Hey, Abbot, open the door.
In the pale devil's night. He took the forbidden knowledge!
Shh, it's all right. I've cleared the way out. Can you walk?
Well, not really. No, I only cleared one side.
Remains must never leave. Unto evening I shall keep it safe, and into the night hereafter.
We must protect the archive.
Ow. This reminds me a bit of Act 1 from Diablo 2, and maybe even more so from Diablo 3, like being in the, like a cathedral or whatever it's called, the catacombs.
Were opened, and I saw the coming darkness. Through the day, I had prepared to accept the burden of knowledge.
Thank you for not making me have to choose which came first and which came last. I wouldn't have remembered. I would have to have gone back and read them again. This is interesting. Okay.
Deserve to burn with the rest of it.
Where is Elias?
Gone. He said the ruin of Sanctuary was imminent and only I could help. He is going to summon a lesser evil. He took all he needed. And then my scholars. He murdered them.
He... Oh.
Forgive me.
Okay. Hammer, go bang.
It shall be shared among the children of Lilith, and no secret shall be kept from them. And the liars and learned thieves of the world shall perish in their regret.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say, is it gonna honestly make me walk all the way back there? But then I saw that he's actually back in town. Yeah, sure, why not? It's interesting that it puts the gems at the end like that. How much money do I have? 37? I'm wondering if I should just sell all this stuff. I feel like I have enough materials.
What did he take?
Scrolls from the Forbidden Archive. He has the means to summon a lesser evil.
Him what? Which bloody one? Where? Oh, we don't know, of course. Elias could cover the steps in blood, but a lesser could wipe out the continent, or worse. Come, Elias's pet demon is inside. Pray it leads us to him.
It was protecting that fool, Genmar.
This is Elias's work. But where is he? The answer lies in the stomach. This is delicate. A soft noble's hand. Elias would have to feed this thing with more than fancy boots.
That's someone's son.
Or daughter.
We should burn demons.
This is wrong.
This medallion bears the crest of the ruler of the royal house of Gul'ran.
Former ruler.
Obviously.
That's enough, old man. The dead deserve respect.
The dead deserve nothing when the living are in danger. Now Gul'ran has a new ruler, and we have Elias to thank for it.
The dead may be worthless to you, but that medallion could bring peace to those.
Maybe this will be the
fine.
The YouTube
if
video thumbnail.
Elias, then we must also travel to Gul'ran.
Laura digging in the guts of a dead demon, strapped to a cross.
Oh, and avoid the city gates. Too many cannibals. Go to the cliffs. We'll find help there.
Okay. Oh. Now see, that's a good one. Basic skills Gant. Jeez, Gant. Grant 20% damage reduction. Wait a second. Didn't I already have that? For 6 seconds. So mine is actually better. For 2 seconds, yeah. Interesting. Oh my god, it's all the way over there. Whatever. Guess I'll start making my way over. Luckily, I move pretty quick. I'd move even quicker with a horse, though. Well, that was kind of a waste of a shrine. Stronghold here. I'll save that for another time. Oh, that's cool. You have to be up there to cross. Oh, I was hoping that would launch me up there. Ah! thought it would let me jump down there. Apparently not. Oh, these are new enemies. They were also almost kicking my ass there, so I'll have to keep an eye on them. Can't get over there this way. Oh, is this going to be another town? Maybe not. Seems to be a lot of lag. These enemies can leap too. Jesus. Well, I don't think that's a city I really want to be a part of. There seems to be a little bit of blood in this area.
Yeah.
That's not bad. I only lost one.
Here. You deserve this.
That was a waste. Oh, there is another city up here. There's nothing over here, right? No.
Oh, she's gone. I can't believe it.
Oh, so it's not a city. There's just kind of a waypoint in the middle of nowhere. Interesting.
Come. Pity you didn't bring an army or siege works.
Elias is here.
That's a cool view.
Gone to the palace, no doubt. Behind the high wall with the gates barred behind him. We can't get through.
You know who can.
Dude, I can get through anything.
Zelaya.
Sure. How many messages did I send? Huh? How long has Oyun been missing? Trapped in there with those butchers? She may be the only one left who knows of the tunnel.
If she's still alive, if this tunnel exists at all.
You don't trust me.
Of course not. You're a thief. Useful years ago, true. But it's clear you have some other reason to seek this, or you.
Not your business.
If I were to look for Oyun, where would I start?
She has a house in the market square. We were supposed to meet there before, but I couldn't get close.
Tried to come back alive. Not convinced this Oyun is worth the risk, but perhaps she'll prove me wrong.
Have a little faith for once, old man.
Oh, look at that. Basic skills gain. So that's the same as that weapon that I got. Except mine is up to 30%. Well, I think I'm pretty much at the end of the night, but maybe I'll go to one side quest. This one's really close to the waypoint, so seems like a good choice. Oh. Okay. Very nice.
The mark of a mercenary company from the days of Ash. Killed man, Blackwheeled Company. The last time they visited. Ruthless mercenaries from the days of Ash. Took any contract that only the desperate.
Smoke?
No. Can you see to the source of this?
I'll see no harm.
I guess I'll go look at that. What is this thing? Okay, these traps are getting out of hand.
You're not the bear.
Half buried traps and a lookout who doesn't mind his back. Predictable and disappointing. The bear has finally left its den. You never should have returned here. Donan sought able bodies and conscripted our lot to defeat Astaroth. Our ruthless tactics were put to measure, but the things I saw, my kin, and our leader, Stanna, I was there when they set upon Breon. So I cut them down after years of quiet. It seemed...
Meet me at the Goose. We'll see the Black Wheel together. Trap failed. The pyres prove they are still drawn to the demon's work. I'll join you there.
Oh my god, this thing's still not done. That's gonna have to wait till next time.
Your return honors me. Sound selection. Interesting choice.
You know what I haven't looked at in a while is my like available transmogs or whatever. Nothing new in there. Doesn't appear to be anything new in here either. Jeez, there's nothing new anywhere. Okay. Well, maybe there are new stuff, it's just not highlighting it. Because I don't remember some of these. Try something different there. I'm trying to sort of go for like a theme of some sort. I don't know. I love this hammer. I don't know. Maybe we'll go back to this thing. Alright, there we go. I'm certainly looking like a walking arsenal, which is cool. Alright, and that is it for tonight. Oh, wrong button. Multiple times pressing the wrong button. Alright, that's it for tonight. I will see you again next time. See you later.